The following program is made possible by the generous support of Bob and Glenda Ontiveros.
Hello and welcome to Mercado on 5th. I'm Emmanuel Juarez.
And I'm Eric Juarez, and we will be your hosts as we take a look at Hispanic history.
By the way, do you know what Mercado means?
It means market. My brother's right. We're going to take you through a bit of Hispanic history.
Now that might sound kind of dry, but the characters involved are anything but.
Like Don Miguel Hidalgo y Costilla. Father Hidalgo was a priest who wasn't exactly a rule follower and started a revolution.
He was pretty unconventional. He danced and gambled and even had kids.
And he felt passionately about freedom, wanting Mexico to break away from 300 years of Spanish rule.
So while we take a look around Mercado 1/5, find out more about Don Miguel Hidalgo y Costilla.
One man sparked the end of 300 years of Spanish rule in Mexico and helped to usher in the beginning of the Mexican War of Independence. His name? Father Miguel Hidalgo. A Roman Catholic priest, unafraid of challenging authority, he was well known for his unconventional practices. He danced, gambled, and most shockingly of all, fathered up to 8 children. But he was also a strongly beloved priest among the people of Querétaro, especially because of his efforts to improve living conditions for the poor and to relieve citizens of the struggles of Spanish rule. Using his influence, he actively questioned the absolute authority of the Spanish king and organized secret meetings in his home, encouraging the townspeople to band together to work toward a common goal, independence. Ready to fight back against the unjust tyranny of the Spanish crown, the people began to plot their path to freedom, and the revolution, the conspiracy of Querétaro, began to take shape. In early 1810, Father Hidalgo was voted a leader of the conspiracy for his moral influence and close relations with the citizens of the surrounding area. And in December of that year, he was picked to head the rebellion. He was joined by Captain Ignacio Allende. However, in the midst of the revolutionary planning and attempts to recruit members, their plan was discovered by Spanish spies in September 1810. Father Hidalgo and Captain Allende were away in Dolores, Guanajuato at the time of the discovery, and the news didn't reach them until 2 days later. Early on the morning of September 16, Hidalgo rang the church bells and issued an urgent call to arms against their Spanish oppressors, cementing his legacy in history for his legendary Cry of Dolores and marking the beginning of the Mexican War of Independence. Within days, hundreds of people answered the call, and within weeks, thousands. Thus began the revolt of Hidalgo. The two leaders guided their army towards Mexico City to recapture the capital, and by October 30th, the army had grown to nearly 80,000 soldiers. However, the partnership suffered when Allende, a professional Spanish soldier, refused to follow Hidalgo's war strategies. The army, divided between their loyalty to each man, disbanded. Until early in January of 1811, when Allende and his troops encountered General Félix Calleja and were forced to return to Hidalgo. The Battle of Calderon Bridge on January 17 proved to be the final stand of Father Hidalgo and Captain Allende as a united force, when, with a stroke of luck, the Spanish army fired a cannonball that fell upon the rebels' munitions and set them ablaze. In the chaos, the majority of Hidalgo and Allende's untrained army fled, leaving the few remaining to escape on their own, including the two leaders. On their escape out of Guadalajara, the group was betrayed by another rebel commander, Ignacio Elizondo. Hidalgo and Allende were taken captive on March 21, 1811 in the city of Chihuahua. On June 26, Captain Allende and two other rebel commanders were executed, followed by Father Hidalgo on July 30. Their heads were sent to Guanajuato, the city of their first real battle, and put on display around the city's granary. Although Father Hidalgo's personal involvement in the 11-year-long war was short, his crime and his cause persevered in the hearts of his followers, who finally achieved their independence on August 24, 1821. To this day, large celebrations take place all throughout Mexico on September 16, the anniversary of Hidalgo's famous crime. And in Mexico City, each Mexican president reenacts the cry of Dolores by ringing the church bell, carrying Hidalgo's cry throughout each new year.
It's amazing that the spark that one man can generate. Because of Hidalgo and his cry of Dolores, Mexico exists as a country today. But his call to arms was just the beginning. The Mexican War of Independence had many heroes who fell in the march to freedom that began in 1810 and didn't end until September 16, 1821. There were many victories and setbacks along the way. There were many leaders who were executed for their pains to make Mexico free. There would be many other struggles, like the Mexican Revolution from 1910 to 1920, but the rich history of Mexico dating back to the Mayan Empire and the Aztec Empire allow us to understand the Mexico of today with its mix of cultures and traditions. Let's take a look back at the timeline and history of the Mexican War of Independence.
The Mexican War of Independence was sparked by Father Hidalgo's Grito de Dolores and the violent revolts that soon followed. However, Hidalgo's involvement in the cause was cut short July 1811, when he was captured and executed. Although his death marked the end of the first phase of insurgency for the revolution, his passion carried on through the hearts of his followers. Under the leadership of José María Morelos y Pavón, a student of Hidalgo and gifted strategist, he redeveloped the revolution with a clearer vision for a unified and free Mexico. He utilized his organizational and political skills and established a Declaration of Independence and a draft of a constitution. However, 4 years after the death of Hidalgo, Morelos was overthrown by rivals to the movement while defending the rebel government and was executed in November 1815. Without the guidance of Morelos, the revolution collapsed into a cluster of isolated revolts and guerrilla resistance beginning in the year 1815. It wasn't until 1820 when one major revolutionary leader emerged from the ranks, Vicente Guerrero. 38 years old at the time, Guerrero had been an active insurgent for 11 years, continuously rising through the ranks. He achieved increasing respect and loyalty from his followers. Guerrero soon proved to be the only major revolutionary leader refusing to surrender to appeals of the Spanish government, and propelled his insurgent army through victories across the region of southern Mexico, including Santa Fe, Tetala del Río, Tlalchapa, and Huetamo. He and his troops were experts in guerrilla warfare, and in response, the royal government assigned military official Agustín de Iturbide to extinguish the remaining rebellion sustained by Guerrero's forces. However, Guerrero defeated Iturbide and appealed to the official to renounce his loyalty to the royal government and join the fight for Mexican independence. At that time, events in Spain were diminishing conservative and Catholic power in Mexico. Independence from Spain would be necessary if they were to maintain their control. Therefore, Iturbide accepted Guerrero's appeal to Mexican independence, and the two united under the Plan de Iguala. Iturbide and Guerrero developed a template for independence in February of 1821. The plan provided three guarantees: preservation of the Catholic Church's status, the independence of Mexico as a constitutional monarchy, and the equality of Spaniards and criollos. Together, Iturbide and his Spanish troops, and Guerrero and the Mexican insurgent army, united as the Army of the Three Guarantees. Support for the plan was widespread among both civilians and military officials, but the battles against Spanish royalist forces continued. The Spanish government sent Viceroy Juan de Odonuju in an attempt to regain control of the uprising. Mexican independence was not guaranteed. The newly unified Army of Three Guarantees marched to Mexico City and defeated the loyalist forces along the way. The Spanish viceroy, recognizing Spain's defeat and with no means or power to oppose the movement any longer, signed the Treaty of Cordoba, granting Mexico its freedom and bringing an official end to the Mexican War of Independence.
It's really great to see the tradition of the ringing of the church bell continue, reminding us of the sacrifice of so many to create the country we see today. Obviously, the Mexican War of Independence is important to the Hispanic population, but there's one other Mexican holiday that we're going to highlight that is celebrated even more by Americans, Cinco de Mayo, which means 5th of May. It is the date the Mexican army was victorious over France at the Battle of Puebla. The town of Puebla is located about 85 miles east of Mexico City, and it is the site of a battle between a small Mexican army under the command of Ignacio Zaragoza and a larger French army. It was a classic David over Goliath story, and it's been celebrated ever since. Like I said, it's a minor holiday in Mexico, but in the United States, Cinco de Mayo has become a celebration of Mexican culture and heritage, especially in places with large Mexican-American populations, featuring parades, guacamole, and margaritas. It's in the top five of drinking holidays. It's not just St. Patrick's Day that has that distinction, and it's not just the Southwest that celebrates. America has marketed the holiday, allowing it to be celebrated nationwide. But it really is more than just an excuse for Mexican restaurants to feature taco specials. It was a significant battle in Mexican history.
Cinco de Mayo is a commonly misunderstood celebration. Many believe it to be Mexico's Independence Day. In fact, it is actually a day that commemorates a battle that occurred 41 years after Mexico's independence was won, the Battle of Puebla. During the years following Mexico's independence from Spain in 1821, the country faced mass economic and political instability, which eventually led to the 1857 Reform War. The Reform War was a civil war that lasted 4 years between conflicting political parties. Ultimately, this war left Mexico's infrastructure and economy crippled and provoked the 1861 French intervention in Mexico, in which the famous Battle of Puebla, or Cinco de Mayo, occurred. Prior to the Reform War, Mexico was already in severe debt to the countries of Great Britain, Spain, and France, but Mexico had slowly been paying their loans. After the war ended, Mexico's new president, Benito Juarez, suspended paying back foreign debt because the country simply didn't have enough money. Despite promising to resume payments in 2 years, the three countries, who had given a substantial amount of money to the new country, were not satisfied. They banded together and seized the primary ports of Mexico in order to force the country into paying its financial reparations. However, France had other plans: to overthrow Mexico City and install a French monarch. Spain and Great Britain had only wanted reimbursement for their money, and withdrew from the alliance when France's intent became known, and it was left up to Mexican resistance to fight off the invaders. In 1862, a powerful French army of nearly 6,000 soldiers arrived at the Veracruz port and pushed through towards Mexico City. But on May 5th, they encountered a surprise along the way. A much smaller Mexican army, armed with inadequate weapons and little proper training, consisting of approximately 4,500 soldiers, set up defenses around the city of Puebla. The French army attacked 3 times and were forced to retreat each time. when their cannons ran out of ammunition, 33-year-old Mexican commander Ignacio Zaragoza commanded the Mexican forces to attack, and the French had to withdraw, losing the battle. The triumph didn't last long. The French army received 27,000 more reinforcements, and Mexico City was eventually captured. But May 5th marks a timeless day in history for Mexican resistance against their imperialist foe. It was an unlikely victory for the Mexican forces against such an overwhelming opponent, an act of determination and bravery. Besides being commonly mistaken for Mexico's Independence Day, what many also do not know is that Cinco de Mayo is in fact not a national holiday in Mexico. The main celebration occurs primarily within Puebla, with reenactments of the battle, military parades, and festivals. Originally celebrated in America by Mexicans who resided in Texas and California, which had been previous Mexican territories, the tradition expanded to other states and cities within the U.S. Cinco de Mayo is celebrated in the U.S. with parades, festivals, fireworks, bands, and of course, eating and drinking. Los Angeles, California actually hosts the world's largest Cinco de Mayo celebration, an event known as Fiesta Broadway, surpassing in size even the celebrations in Puebla, and is attended by hundreds of thousands of people. The celebration of Cinco de Mayo in the United States has evolved into a holiday that celebrates not a battle, but the Mexican way of life and culture, and has turned into a source of revenue by the restaurants and pubs. But in Mexico, it remains a day of respect for the lives lost against an invading foe.
Here at Mercado, we can dance to traditional music, shop, and immerse ourselves in the culture of the Quad Cities. It's fitting that behind this market is a Floreciente neighborhood that was a gateway for immigrants to settle in this area. Folks looking for a new beginning who came from Sweden to Belgium to Mexico and Africa.
We hope you're inspired to discover other immigrant stories in history. So right now, it's time to dance. Thank you.